Hello guys, welcome to First Step Future India. Today we're going to see about NCERT Class 11 Geography book, India Physical Environment, in that Chapter 4, Climate. So let us see what are the contents of this lesson. The first one is introduction. In introduction, we will study what is climate, what is weather, and what India have as a climate, and what are the regional differences in India. And the second one is determining the factors that affects climate. Depending upon these factors only, we have different kinds of weathers and climate patterns. So what are those? Location and relief, air pressure and winds. Third one is weather mechanism in winter and summer. So there is a separate weather mechanisms for summer as well as for winter. So we will be seeing that. And fourth one is nature of Indian monsoon. Fifth, the rhythm of seasons. And sixth, traditional Indian seasons. And seventh is climatic region of India. Whereas in India, we will be taking certain states and we will study those weather patterns of those particular states. And the last but not least, economic life and global warming, how this affects climate. So let us see. So to study climate, first we have to know what is weather. For example, if I'm taking the place Delhi and the date is Jan 1, so in this particular day, what we experience in the atmospheric region or the environment around us, what we feel and what we experience in this particular day in this Delhi is called weather. So weather is location specific, okay, and time specific. Usually weather is a short term observation of atmospheric conditions, whereas climate is an average of weather for prolonged time, to say about 30 to 50 years. So in this Delhi, if we observe for about 30 to 50 years the weather pattern, finally we can conclude what kind of climate is this places. So depending upon this observation only, we can understand the climate of the particular country or region, okay. So let us see the definition. So weather is a momentary state of an atmosphere, while the climate refers to average of weather condition over a longer period of time, for say 50 years. So what are the factors that we calculate or taken in account to understand weather? So those factors are temperature, pressure, wind direction, velocity, humidity and precipitation. So these are the important factors by which we understand the weather. What I say as atmospheric elements, what we experience in a day. So depending upon this only, we can say what weather we experience as well as what climate we live in, okay. So this is all about climate and weather and the elements of weather and climate. So India basically is a monsoon based country. We can say India has a climate called hot monsoonal climate or tropical monsoonal climate. Not only India, South and Southeast Asia also have monsoonal climate. Even though we say overall India has a monsoonal climate, exactly it is not possible India to have a monsoonal climate entirely. Let us see how. In this map, we can see Tropic of Cancer passes through our India, right? So the places above this Tropic of Cancer is we call as North India, below is South India, and this is central part of India, okay. In this region, we know we have Himalayas, many glaciers, and it is all based on snowfall, right? And here we see major oceans that is surrounded by a peninsula region, right? So this part of the country, mainly the climate of these part are mainly based on the influence on the sea. So sea have its impact on deciding the climate of this region. Whereas in central India, here we have Rajasthan. the dry desert. And here we have northeastern states where the rainfall is very high, right? So from this we can see, or we can say, that entire India is not a monsoonal climate, but majority of India based on the monsoonal rainfall, because this region, Himalayan region, have glaciers as a water source, but the South Indian region and this northeastern region based mainly on the southwest and northeast monsoon winds. So the water resources here are ephemeral, as we saw in the last lessons. So these region of our country is based on the monsoonal rainfall. So this is why we call our India as a hot monsoonal climate or tropical monsoonal climate. I hope you understand it. If you have any doubt in this explanation, let me know in the comment section below. So this regional differences or the climatic differences in our India is called as subtypes of monsoonal climate. Also, I am differentiating this regional variation into two types. First, based on temperature, and second, based on precipitation. So if you take temperature, the same Jan 1, I am taking it as an example. So in this Jan 1, the climate or the weather of Jammu and Kashmir will be different from Tamil Nadu, which is a southern tip of our country, right? And it is also different to island countries like Andaman and Nicobar Islands. So in the same day itself, we can see different weather in single country in different parts. In Jan 1 itself, you can see different weather in Jammu and Kashmir, in Tamil Nadu, in Andaman and Nicobar Islands. In single day, we can see different weather patterns. As well as in single day, if I differentiate again it as a daytime and night time, if you take Rajasthan as an example or a location, here the temperature in daytime is different from temperature during the night time. Whereas in Tamil Nadu, the temperature difference between the daytime and night time will be very negligible amount. Whereas in Rajasthan, it will be extreme or drastic. So in single day itself, we can see this variety of differences or temperature differences in our country, as well as the precipitation. The amount of rainfall we get in this region, Thura, which is located in Meghalaya, the single day rainfall here is equal to annual rainfall, the entire year rainfall we get in West Himalayas and Western deserts of our country. As you know, precipitation is of two types. First one is snowfall and second one is rainfall. Depending upon this snowfall and rainfall only, we get water resources. So our water dependency is based on this only. So the same day, one place of our country will be facing the flood, as well as another part of the country will be facing drought. So this is very common phenomena in our country. This is all because we are monsoonal climate. So this is the introduction of this lesson. Let us see what are the factors that affects this climate and weather. So under the factors determining the climate of India, the first one is location and relief. Depending upon the location of the place and their relief, we experience the types of climate. So the first one is latitude. So as you know, globe is divided into two parts by equator, that is 0 degree, right? So above this, it is a Tropic of Cancer, and this is Tropic of Capricorn, right? So this region is called tropical region. So the countries which falls over here are tropical countries. In tropical countries, it will be usually warm type of weather is prevalent over here. Whereas in equator, throughout the year, there will be the same kind of climate prevails. So there the rainfall is also prevalent, as well as the warm climate is also prevalent over the equator. So there will be no much differences as per the season. We can say in equator region there is no season cycle, there is no much differences in seasons, or there is no season cycle. Okay, so if we take India is in here. So the Tropic of Cancer passes through India, right? So this southern tip of India is nearby equator, whereas the northern tip is in subtropical region. This is one of the reason we have different type of climate in our country. This region, the northern part of India, experiences subtropical climate, whereas the central part experiences the tropical climate, where the southern tip of India experiences the equatorial climate. So this is the factor how latitude affects climate in India. I hope you understand it. Let's see the next one. The next one is Himalayan mountain. Without Himalayan mountain, we would not be experience the present climate in India. If there is no Himalayan mountain, we would be freezing. And India would be the part of polar region, because Himalayan mountain is the feature which blocks the cold air from the Arctic region, that is from the Siberian winds are blocked by Himalayan mountains, so that after Himalayas we have life or vegetation which is different from them, from the Arctic Circle. This Himalayan mountain acts as a climatic divide. Also, this is one of the reason we get rain from the monsoonal winds in Indian subcontinent. So Himalayas is beneficial as a blockage from the Siberian winds, as well as the rainfall from the monsoonal winds to the Indian subcontinent. So this is how Himalayan mountain plays a vital role in the weather and climate pattern of India. And the next one is distribution of land and water. In India, we have both land and water in high proportion. So when you compare the land and water, land get warm easily as well as cools down easily, whereas water doesn't get warm up easily or cools down easily. So this differential heating between the land and water makes the pressure difference. This is one of the reason why we get rain during the monsoonal season, and the climate and weather patterns what we experience in India. The next one is distance from the sea. So as I have told you, water will not get cool down or warm up easily. So the coastal region have different climates from the inlands of our country. The coastal region of our country will always have same kind of climate throughout the year, whereas the inland will have different climate since it is away from the water. The climate in North India or the central part of India is also different, because the distance from the sea, that is from Bay of Bengal and Arabian Sea, is high in this region. They have very less influence of sea compared to the coastal region or southern part of India. This is how the weather and climate are influenced by the sea or the land distance from the sea. Okay, so let us see about altitude. So as we know, as the altitude increases, temperature decreases. So in upper lands or plateaus, we have different kind of climates compared to the plains. This is all because of, as the altitude increases, temperature decreases. They are inversely proportional to each other. And the relief, such as temperature, pressure, direction and speed of wind, amount and distribution of rainfall, depending upon this also, the climate weather differs to region to region. As well as we have to know what is windward and leeward region of the mountain. If I take one mountain, So this is the windward region and this is the leeward region. Windward region is nothing but it can make the moisture out of air. So windward region, when it gets the air, it leads to the condensation and precipitation. So here the rainfall is prevalent, whereas in leeward it blocks the air. So here it will be warm and no precipitation occurs. So this is the difference between windward and leeward. Windward, here we have moist and precipitation or condensation will happen, but in leeward it will be warm and no precipitation occurs. So depending upon these reliefs also, the weather and climate of the region can be determined. The second factor that related to or affecting the climate and weather is air pressure and wind. Both this happens in the atmospheric region of our earth. So the first one is distribution of air pressure and winds on the surface of the earth. So the air pressure and winds plays the major role here. And the second one is differences in air mass and jet stream due to the global weather. So depending upon the air mass and jet stream, the climate and weather gets differences. These happens in the atmospheric region, whereas this happens in the surface of the earth. And the third one is tropical depression. The events happened in one part of country or one part of the world that affects the another part in the world is one of the major reasons for the climate and weather of a particular region. For example, the rainfall due to the southwest monsoon is also influenced from the western part of the Europe. So the disturbances in one part affects the another part or one country to another country. So these are the two major factors that affects the weather and climate of the any region in the earth. So this is the end of the part 1 video. I'm going to split this lesson into 3. So this is the end of the part 1. I hope you understood what I have taught you till now. If you like this video, kindly hit the like button. Share this video with the serious candidates just like you. If you have any suggestions or requests, don't hesitate to share in the comment section below. If you have not subscribed the channel yet, kindly subscribe it because you don't want to miss the future videos as well. So thank you. Study well. Bye.